हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करसगी ऑर्किड चैनल। आई एम वीना टीचर टीचिंग यू फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड मैथ्स। व्हाट डिड यू स्टडी इन आवर लास्ट सेशन स्टूडेंट्स? यस वी हैव सॉल्व आवर एक्सरसाइज 5.1 एंड वी हैव स्टार्टेड वन न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज फैक्टर्स एंड फाइंडिंग द फैक्टर्स। Now let us revise quickly what are the two ways that we have studied how to find out the factors. The first one is finding factors with the multiplication, isn't it? You can use the multiplication to find the factor of number. So what was the rule? When we multiply two numbers, so we get the product. Which product? Whatever number they give. Now for example, 24 they had given. Whenever we multiply two or more number, we should get the same product. Okay, so whatever the numbers we are multiplying, those are factors of that given number, isn't it? And the second thing we have seen that we can find out the factors by using division also. How? So a factor of a number divides the number without leaving a remainder is called a factor. Now suppose they had given 18. So with 18, whatever number you divide, so there should not be any remainder. There should be no remainder. Okay. So then only that number is factor of that given number. Understood? Yes. We have studied deeply in our last session. Now it's time to solve our exercise 5.2. Isn't it? Now we will start question number A. What is the question number A? Fill in the blanks. Question first, 8 multiplied by 7 is equals to 54. 8 sevens are 56, isn't it? Now they had given fill in the blanks. 56 is a dash dash of 7 and 8. What we have done? 56 is a? Yes. Tell me, what is 56? What we have done here? See this symbol? Which symbol it is? Multiple. Very good. Correct. So 56 is a multiple of 7 and 8. Okay. Now full stop. The next, what they had given? 7 and 8 are dash dash of 56. Tell me, the 7 and 8, what are they? Yes. What are they? So whenever we multiply any two number, we get the product. So those numbers are called factors, isn't it? So 7 and 8 are factors of 56, isn't it? Clear? Understood? I'll repeat again. Now 8 multiplied by 7 is equals to 56 they had given, and in the fill in the blanks, 56 is a dash dash of 7 and 8. What we have done to 56? Multiple with what of 7 and 8? 7 and 8, multiplication symbol, so write multiple. And 7 and 8 are what? Factors of 56, isn't it? Now see the second, 6 multiplied by 7 is equals to 42. Now here 42 is a multiple of, 42 is a multiple of, what are the numbers? Yes, see here, 6 and 7. So write here 6 and 7. Full stop. Now dash dash and dash dash are factors of 42. Yes, tell me, what are the 42 factors? Yes, exactly. Whenever we multiply two numbers to get the product, those numbers are called factors of given numbers. So 6 and 7 again. So write here 6 and 7 are the factors of 42. Understood? Clear till here? Yes. Now we'll move to the B question. What is the B question? List all the factors of the following numbers. See, now we have to list. Now we will list one by one. Exercise 5.2 B question. In that first one, what is the first one? 32. What we have to do with 32, students? We have to list all the factors of the following number, isn't it? Now, see how we can find out with multiplication and division. Okay, whichever you feel easy, you can go with that. So, I suggest you go with the multiplication. Means, if you know the table perfectly, so you can do it fast. Now, let me revise that. When you multiply two or more number, we get a product. So, whenever we multiply both the numbers, that we should get the 34. So, the product of multiple of each number multiplied, isn't it? So, that each number is a factor of that given product. Now, we'll start with 1. 1 multiplied by 32, what we get? 32. Now, what multiplied by 2 will get the 32? Yes. Think everyone. Can you? Yes. Very good. 16 multiplied by 2, we get 32. Now, what about 3? Can we multiply with 3 any number to get the 32? Yes. Think everyone. Yes. Is it possible? No, it is not possible, because when we multiply with 3 with any number, we will not get 32. See, think about 3 table or 9 table, 7 table, 32 is there? No, it is not there. So, we will go with the 4. With 4, if we multiply any number, we should get 32 as a product. Now, see, 4 8s are 32, isn't it? Are you getting what I am trying to tell you? 4 8s are 32, isn't it? Now, what about 5? In 5 table, 32 is there? No, 35 is there. What about 6 table? 6 5s are 30, 6 6s are 36. So, 32 is not there in 6 table. What about 7? Yes. In 7 table, 32 is there? Yes. 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35 again. So, it is not there. What about 8 table? Yes, in 8 table, 32 is there? Yes, it is there. 8 4s are 32, isn't it? Yes. Now, what about 9 table? 9 4s are 36, so it is not there. What about 10? No, 10 3s are 30. What about 11? 11 3s are 33. So, we should find out that in each table, 32 should be there. Then only we can write the multiplication of both the numbers. So, whenever we multiply both the numbers, we should get the product, isn't it? Now, what about 12? 12 2s are 24, 12 3s are 36. No, that is also not there. 13, 13 2s are 26, 13 3s are 39. No, what about 14? 14 2s are 28, 14 3s are 42. It's going very big number. We are searching for 32, isn't it? What about 14? Yes, tell me. No, it is not there. 14 1s are 14, 14 2s are 28. What about 15? 15 2s are 30. What about 16? Yes, 16 2s are 32. Isn't it? Yes. So, here after 16, 17 2s are what will come? Yes, 34. So, it's going greater number. So, we should stop here. Now, whenever we multiply both the numbers, we get the same product, we should get the product. Okay. In the same way, we have done these multiplication. When we have multiplied this both the numbers, we got this. This is what? Product. Which number they had given. Okay. Now, what we have done? The product is multiple of each of the number multiplied. So, this each number is what? Factors of the given number, isn't it? So, you can write here the factors of 32 is, see, 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. Full stop. Are you getting? In this way you have to write 16 and see one more. 8, 16 and 32 itself. We have studied. Do you remember? Every number is factor of 1 and itself. Keep in your mind. Every number have factor of 1. Smallest factor is 1 and the greatest factor is itself. Isn't it? So keep in your mind. So first always comes 1 and at the end the number comes itself. Clear? Understood? Yes. Now I will solve next question. Now question number 3 I will solve. Third one. Number 18. Okay. Now see. First start with 1 only. 1 18s are 18 because as I said every number is factor of 1. Okay. Every number lowest factor is always 1 and the greatest factor is always number itself. Okay. Now next 1 after 2. In 2 table 18 is there? Yes, it is there. Where it is? When we multiply 2 multiplied by 9, we get the product 18. 2 9s are 18. What about 3? 3 6s are 18. So right here. What about 4? 4 4s are 16. 4 5s are 20. 18 will not get. So we will not go with 4. So before writing, think first. Okay. What about 5? Because you are using pen now, isn't it? So it is not possible to rub. I am using marker so I can rub. But what about you? So first think, then go, then write. Okay. Now what about 5? 5 5s are 20. Sorry, 5 4s are 20. Isn't it? So 18 is not there. What about 6? 6 3s are 18. So I can take 6 3s are 18. What about 7? 7 2s are 14. 7 3s are 21. No. What about 8? 8 2s are 16. No. What about 9? Yes. 9 2s are 18. Isn't it? What about 10? 10 2s are 20. So it's going now greater number. Isn't it? So what is the last number will come directly after that? 18 1s are 18. Isn't it? So we can write here now the answer. The factors of 18, yes, are, if we are writing 1, we should write is. If more than 1 numbers are there, we should write are. So what are the factors here? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9 and 18. Getting? Now I'll solve next question. Fifth one I will solve now. What is the fifth one? 15. Okay. Now see. Start with 1. 1 15s are 15. Now in 2 table 15 is there, students? No, it is not there. We cannot multiply any number with 2 to get the 15 product. Go with the 3. Yes, in 3 table 15 is there. Think everyone. 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15. Yes, we can. So right. What about 4? 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16. No, it is not there. What about 5? Yes, 5 3s are 15. What about 6? 6 2s are 12. No. 7 2s are 14, no. 8 2s are 16, no. 9 2s are 18, no. 10 2s are 20, no. 11, no. 12, no. 13, no. Directly it goes to 15, 1s are 15. Are you getting? So here you can write at the end the factors of 15 are, what are the factors? 1, 3, 5 and 15. See, observe, whenever I am writing the factors, the lowest factor is 1 and the highest, largest, biggest factor is 15, means itself, number itself. Okay, clear till here? Yes. Now I will solve one more example for you. Now I'll take ninth number. What is the ninth number? Question. It's 16. Big number it is. Okay. Now we will see. First, lowest start with 1. Once multiplied by 60, we get 60. Now what about 2? Yes. When you multiply with 30, we get 60. Now what about 3? See, when we multiply 3 with 20, we get 60. What about 4? Yes. Think everyone. Yes, we can multiply. 4 multiplied by 15, we get 60. Okay. Now what about 5? Yes, even we get with 5 also 60. 5 multiplied by 12 is 60. What about 6? Yes, of course, 6 tens are 60, isn't it? What about 7? No, in 7 table it is not there. What about 8? No. 9? No. 10? No. 11? No, because 11 6 are 66. What about 12? Yes, in 12 table it is there. Yes, 12 5 are 60. In 13 table? Yes, it is there. No. What about 14? No. What about 15? Yes, it is there. 15 folds are 16. What about 16? No. 17? No. 18? Not there. What about 19? No. 20? Yes, in 20 table 6 is there, 60 is there. 23 is a 60, isn't it? Now after that directly it comes 30 table. 32 is a 60, and at the end 31 is a, sorry, at the end 60. 61 is a 60. See, so many factors of 60 are. So here we can write answer. I don't have space, so I am writing here. The factors of 60 are, what are? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, 15, 20, 30 and 60. Lowest is 1, largest is number itself. Understood? Clear? Clear till here? Yes? Yes. Now I will solve one more example for you. Now 11th number we will solve. What is the 11th number? Can you tell? 14. Very easy. Now see, 1 14 is a 14, correct? In 2 table 14 is there? Yes. 2 7 is a 14. What about 3? No. 4? No. 5? No. 6? No. 7? 7 2 is a 14. And at the end 7? No. Not 7. Directly 14 1 is a 14. So what are the factors? The factors of 14 are 1, 2, 7 and 14. Clear? Understood? Yes? Very good. Now I will solve last one more for you. Thirteen number. The number is 67. See the number 67. See, what about 67? We'll start with 1. 1, 67s are 67. See, 67 is there in any number, students? Just think. No, 67 is not there in any table because the number is there in number itself only. So, at the end, we can write 67 ones are 67. So, the factors of, better I'll write here only. So, what are the factors? The factors of 67 are 1 and 67. Only these two. Are you getting? See, here I would like to introduce one concept with this question. So, in question, whenever the numbers which have only two factors. Now see, in this number we are getting only two factor. And what are those? First is number 1 and the second is number itself. These numbers are called prime numbers. What I said, I'll repeat again. Numbers which have only two factors. The first is 1 and the second is number itself. Okay. So these are called prime number. What is prime number? Prime spelling? P-R-I-M-E. Prime number. Okay. With this question, I would like to introduce one more concept. Number which have more than two factors are called composite number. Okay. What is composite? The number which have more than two factors. See, here 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 factors are there. The number which have more than two factors are called composite number. The number which have only two factors, first is 1 and the number itself, these numbers are called prime number. Clear? Clear till here? Understood? Yes. Now, we'll move to next concept. Here we have completed our exercise 5.2. Now, what is your today's home assignment, students? Now, you will solve remaining all questions in your rough book. Okay? Practice all sums. See, as we have studied about the factors, now, for example, 2. 2 is having 2 factors, 2 and 5. What I say, 2 and 5 are the friends of 10. Means 2 and 5 are the factors of 10. Isn't it? Isn't it? Yes. So once what happened, the number 18 was thinking that who are my factors, was very sad. And he was thinking, what are my factors? So suddenly what happened, 18 observed 3. See, then what he decided that how the branches of trees break or split into smaller branches. So, what 18 thought, why can't I do that to myself also? See, what 18 was thinking that how the branches of tree break or split into the smaller branches. So, in the same way, why can't I do that to myself? So what he decided that what if I split like branches of tree into smaller numbers? See, I'll show you the tree. See, this is a tree. Okay, you can see the branches, isn't it? These branches are split, isn't it, into smaller branches. So 18 was thinking, I can also split into the smaller numbers to get my factors, isn't it? Yes or no? Now see, 2 multiplied by 9 is 18. Here 9 we can split for the further, isn't it? We can, 9 can be further split up, split up. So 9 will come in 3 table. 3 3s are 19. See, what is 2 and 9? 2 and 9 is cofactors of 18. And now 9 can split up into 3 into 3 is 9. So 3 and 3 is factors of 9. Isn't it? So, and here again we can split up 3. 3 ones are 3. And here also 3 ones are 3. And here 2 ones are 2. But here we cannot do. Why? Why? Because again now 2 is there. Again it can split up 2 ones are 2. Again 2 is there. It can go 2 ones are 2. So when the number is having only 2 factors, that is 1 and the number itself. Now see, this number is having 2 factors. What is that? 1 and 2 number itself. Okay. So that time we should not split. Isn't it? So here I will stop with 2 only, because 2 is a prime number. And what about 3? See, when I split 3, I get 3 and 1. Again 3, I can split 3 into 1, isn't it? But 3 and 1 is what? The factors of 3. Now 3 is having only 2 factors, that is 1 and the number itself. So we should not go for the further splitting. Here I should stop. Okay. Now today we will study, what we are going to study? Factors tree. Yes, factors tree. Now have a look on tree. Now look at here. Now here I am having on the top of the tree 6. Okay. Now I want to split this 6. How can I split this 6, students? Yes. What are the factors of 6? What numbers we can multiply to get the 6? See, here I am having some numbers. If I take 2 and 3. What is this 2 and 3? 2 multiplied by 3, we get 6. Are you getting? 2 multiplied by 3, we get 6. So 2 3s are 6. So 2 and 3 is what? Factors of 6. So 6 can be split up into 2 and 3. Are you getting? Yes. Now I'll go with the another number. Here now I will take 12. Okay. Now how can I split up 12, students? Yes. 6 2's are 12, isn't it? Yes, see, 6 2's are 12. Now here 2, when I split up again, what I get? I get again 2 and the 1. See, again this 2 can split up, isn't it? So 2 is what? Prime number. We should stop. We should not split up, because it is never ending. Prime number we should not split. So I will cancel here. We should stop here only. But 6 I can split up. How? See, when I multiply 3 with 2, I get the 6, isn't it? 3 multiplied 2 is 6. So the end of the branches, whatever the numbers are there, those numbers are called the factors of given number. Now see, what are the smaller branches? 3, 2 and 2. So number 3, 2, 2 is a factors of 12. Are you getting? Yes. Yes. These numbers when we multiply, we get the 12 number. See, 3 multiplied by 2, we get the 6. Again 6 multiplied by 2 means 6 2s are 12. Are you getting? In this way. Now one more example I'll take. Now for example 24. Here 24 is there. Now how can I split up this 24, students? Tell me. Yes. Can you? Yes. I can take 12 2's are 24. Now we can split up again 12. See, how can I? 6, 2's are 12, isn't it? Now again 6 we can split up, isn't it? So I'll split up the 6 again. How? With number 3 and 2. 3 2's are 6. Are you getting what is factors tree? Yes. Are you getting? See, the following, whatever I am showing, this is the factors tree. Okay. They show the factors of a number, and the number 1 is not shown to the factors tree. Since, because number 1 is a factor of every number, so we will not continue with the number 1. Clear till here? Yes. Understood? Yes. In tomorrow's, now today we have studied about factors tree. Okay, introduction we have done, now in detail, and we will solve our exercise 5.3 in our coming next episode. Okay, till that time, today's home assignment, solve 5.2 in your rough book. Okay, now we will meet in our next session with exercise 5.3. Till that time, bye bye, take care, and thank you.